And we're talking about the young woman. A judge has ruled that the parents have to come up with $16,000 to pay her tuition. So, I mean, I think you know the story that we're going to talk now with Michael Ricci, who is the girl's father. Michael, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
You know, this case should be disturbing to all parents because looks like now the judge is that you're making what appear to be very sound decisions on your family, a member of your family, but the judge has taken that out of your hands, has he not?
Yeah, we feel, you know, this is a family matter.
Yeah.
This should have never seen the inside of a courtroom. You know, decisions on where your kids go to college shouldn't be decided by the courts.
Yeah.
And it should be decided by parents, you know, sitting down. I heard one of your callers earlier say, you know, you sit down and you talk to your kids about, you know, what colleges and universities that they want to that they can afford, and you make a decision that's best for your family.
Yeah.
In this case, we are not saying that we don't want our daughter to go to school. We want her to go to school. You know, we offered her during the situation. We offered her the minimum of $9,000, which is the minimum of what a state university is in New Jersey,
mm-hmm.
and she and her lawyer refused to take it. And in my, you know, in this case, if she wants to go to that college, then she's going to have to pay for it. And, you know, if we had that conversation at home, if she was living at home, if we had the relationship with her, we would have sat down and said, this is what we can afford to go to. And if you want to choose something different, then it's going to be on you.
But the state has taken parenting out of your hands for a 21-year-old.
That's correct.
That's frightening. It's really frightening. So what do you do from here? As we understand it, the court has ordered you, a superior court, to put up the money. What is your recourse now? What can you do?
Well, it's twofold. One is we are appealing the decision. And then we've also been contacted recently from a few legislators that are rewriting, that want to rewrite the law.
Mm-hmm.
Chris Brown, an assemblyman down here in Burlington County, I met with him on Monday. And as you mentioned earlier, you said this Newburgh law was in 1982,
yeah,
right? It needs to be changed. Really, it's a disservice not only to divorced parents, but for parents that are married also.
Sure.
I mean, mm-hmm. to force them to have the courts force them to pay for college is just it's unfair.
The court went along with what would to me as a parent would be patent nonsense, and that is that it is abusive for you to ask her to follow rules and show respect.
And that's really how this all started when she came home from her Disney internship. She came home. She was sent home by Disney for underage drinking. So when she came home, we sat down with her as her mother and father, and kind of we actually wrote up an agreement with her to say, listen, this is to get your life back in order. This is what you need to do. You need to, you know, take summer classes. You're going to get a job, and you're going to do these things around the house and that sort of thing. And 3 days after we presented that to her, she walked out of the house. And so, you know, when she went to her grandparents' house, and, you know, they're as much at fault as anybody, because when we asked them to send her home, they refused. So it's an unusual situation.
Yeah,
it's an unfortunate situation. You know, we love our daughter. We want to have a relationship with her. We want to help
but
her. We just
all you are saying is asking is that she come home, and then you will pay the tuition to a New Jersey institution. That's not asking a whole lot. Parents should be able to ask that of a child that you've raised. It's almost unthinkable. Did the judge, Michael, at any time in that decision indicate that he was not happy having to make that decision, but he was bound by the law or something like that? Or
no, he just said that he saw that because we had gone to mediation and we had been in court twice and we couldn't come to any kind of decision. And he stated that he said, I don't want to see this keep going around and around in a circle, and I'm just making a decision. And he didn't put an end date on it. I mean, he didn't mm-hmm. say this is until 26. I mean, what if she goes to medical school and she goes to school until she's 30? Are we on the hook for that also? I mean, what about her grades too? Like, he didn't put anything, you know, he didn't, it was just, it was an unusual ruling, and it was, you know.
Well, unhappily, if Chris Brown gets this bill even passed, it probably will not be retroactive to cover you, would it?
Well, he's trying to make it so it's
Michael, yeah. Listen, I appreciate it. The best of luck to you. I really feel
so
bad for you.
Thank you so much for having me on.
And I got to run, though, because we have some news coming up. Michael Ricci is the father of this young woman, and